His Excellency Shri K. Shankar Narayanan Ji, His Excellency Dr. D. Y. Patil Ji, Honorable Governor of Tripura, my dear and esteemed friend Yashwant Sinha, Member of Parliament and Chairman Parliamentary Standing Committee Finance, Shri G. N. Bajpai Ji, Chairman of the Selection Committee of YB Chavan Memorial Awards Excellence, Shri Chandrakant Salunke Ji, the main organizer of this event, other office bearers and members of the Maharashtra Industrial and Economic Development Association, distinguished awardees, delegates, invitees, media persons, sisters and brothers. It's indeed a very great day, the 6th Foundation Day of the Association and the 2nd edition of Maharashtra Economic Summit. And the 3rd important thing is that you have listened to a brilliant Yashwantrao Chavan Memorial Lecture by another Yashwant Sinha. I represented Maharashtra in Rajya Sabha. And I said, I am very proud, firstly, to be an Indian, then to be a Maharashtrian, and then, last but not the least, to be a Mumbaikar. Please remember, everybody has an identity. Identity of the place of birth, identity of your profession, your career, so many things. But the identity of you being as a human being is the largest circle. All are right from your birth, family, everything. The others are also circles. None of them is an intersecting circle. And they go round, and the biggest circle is humanity. And I'm proud to be human being. I'm proud to be from Bombay because we are Adivasis. You talk about tribals, aboriginals of Mumbai, you know, Your Excellency, that my family migrated and settled in Mumbai in 1729. In 1828, a family temple was built, which is called Lord Muralidhar Mandir, Thakurji Muralidhar Mandir. I have been also blessed with the same name. And you will not believe that was the first temple to be opened to the Dalits in Maharashtra and probably in India. And that was done by Dr. Ambedkar, leading a team of 100. There were very other illustrious like M.R. Jaikar, the Privy Councillor also there. But I am proud of Mumbai for another reason. When I was a student of the age of 12, I could speak 4 languages very fluently. One was Marathi, second one was Hindi, third one was English, and fourth one was Gujarati. I also knew a bit of Parsi Gujarati. Now, you cannot believe that later on I learnt a little of French also and Urdu also. But this could happen only in Mumbai, Mumbai, Mumbai. Nowhere else, go to Kerala, go to Karnataka, go to Uttar Pradesh, go to Punjab, you will not learn more than 2 languages. So today I am here, which is truly a great cosmopolitan human city of the world. I must tell you that I came here because today is also Yashwantrao Chavan's birth anniversary. He was a multifaceted personality. I knew him intimately And I saw him a day before he left, when he was about to contest the 1984 elections. I used to go to one race course road where he used to live, which was a now part of the Prime Minister's residence complex. And I have known him, what? He was the Chief Minister of Maharashtra, the first Chief Minister of Maharashtra. He was, of course, all the four top ministries, home, defense, external affairs, and finance. He has been everywhere. He was a deputy prime minister. And yet he was so humble, he was so humane. And I take this opportunity to pay my tribute and pay my homage to his very revered memory. I must also tell you at this point of time that I always said in Parliament more than once, and my friend, good friend, will Mr. Yashwant Sinha will bear me out. I said Maharashtra is named Maharashtra because it is Maha in Rashtra. It is the biggest state in Maha. And I think we will achieve and keep that role for eternity because of what we are, the biggest cosmopolitan state. Now, rooted in democracy, rule of law, development. I will not take your time because it is long. I only want to say one thing, that when you talk of economic growth, you have to assimilate it with human development growth. Please don't make any mistake about it, because economic growth has no meaning unless there is human development growth. And please remember, I do not mind rich becoming richer. I do not mind richer becoming the richest. But I do mind, and it pains my heart to see that poor remain poor. Today our aim should be to drive away poverty. And there is a silent revolution. I will tell you what is happening today. We have a lot of illiteracy. And the female illiteracy is more. But wherever I go, up primary school, upper primary schools, high schools, universities, everywhere now, 60% of the students are girls and 40% students, you can check even in Mumbai, and 40% of the students are boys. And therefore, this blot of illiteracy will soon be removed. And as I say, poverty drives you to illiteracy, but literacy drives away poverty. So education is the key to development and health. And you will see that within 10 years, our rate of education will go up. I don't want to talk more about infrastructure. It has been already mentioned. Three things must be there: roads, then there must be schools, and there must be electricity and water. Four things are must. I feel very sorry that you don't build the roads for the villages. What happens is you will build a road for the mines. If you build that road 2 months earlier, two years earlier, the villagers, the tribals will always feel, this is my road and it has been built for me. But unfortunately, what happens is that you build it when the first thing that passes on that road is a huge truck, and they get a feeling of exploitation. So we must remove this spirit of exploitation, and we must work, because we live in a world of human rights where all human beings are born free and equal. And we have to look to see that we remove the ugly spots of poverty and illiteracy from the face of our beautiful, beautiful, one of the most beautiful nations in the world. I have no idea. It is multifaceted democracy. I say India is not only the largest democracy, but I say it and I challenge even USA to deny it, that it is the strongest democracy. You cannot find so much diversity in unity in any other nation. So with these words, I hope your economic summit will ultimately be meant for the people, the people, the people, the people of Maharashtra, and the people of Maharashtra will always take it to the people of India. I wish you all the success in years to come, and I once again profusely thank you for giving me this opportunity and remember my old, old, young days in school and college. Thank you.